You'll notice that Dante Controller doesn't just show you a bunch of IP addresses. That would be very difficult to keep track of. What you see instead is a list of device names. I can even customize these device names under the Device Config tab. And this device will automatically show up with the same custom name the next time it connects to this network, and automatically reconnect with any patches made prior to the disconnecting. But sometimes, such as when you're setting up a new Dante network, you'll see a bunch of default names on the screen. In these cases, it could be difficult to know which device is which. But of course, I've got a few tips for you. First, in a Dante system, you can double-click the device to open the device view, and then navigate to the Identify button under the Devices tab. This will usually trigger a flashing light on the device, so you can name it appropriately. But if your device has no lights, or if it's above a projector in the ceiling, here's another tip. When you're installing a networkable piece of hardware, like a Dante wall plate transmitter, for example, keep a record of which devices were installed in which locations. Of course, you won't know the IP addresses until you connect it to a network, and anyway, the IP address could change down the road, but you can write down the serial number and the MAC address. These two numbers are permanently assigned to the hardware itself. With this info documented, we can easily identify each device by its MAC address, which is shown right here in Dante Controller. If you're not using Dante Controller, you can also see MAC addresses by typing the command ARP space dash A into your computer's terminal. This will return a list of all the devices that are visible on the network based on the IP address and subnet mask of your computer. If you know the IP address of a device that you're trying to communicate with, but you don't see it in a discovery tool like Dante Controller, try this. Open up the terminal on your computer and type in ping and then the IP address that you'd like to reach. If you see a response, that means the device is reachable with your computer's current network settings. But if you don't see a reply, you may need to do some extra troubleshooting. Remember, the MAC address is a unique address that is permanently assigned to the device at the factory. And on the network, that MAC address is assigned an IP address, which will be used to communicate through the switch. A helpful thing to understand here is that a device like a laptop can have more than one MAC address. Each NIC, or Network Interface Card, has a MAC address. That's why it's so important to check which NIC you're configuring in your computer's network settings, and which NIC you're using within Dante Controller. I could be connected properly to a Dante network with my network adapter, but I won't see anything in Dante Controller if I've selected my Wi-Fi adapter in the settings. Verify that you're using the correct network adapter, and if you're still having trouble after that, you can try disabling Wi-Fi and try it again. As I mentioned before, systems like Dante are usually incredibly easy to set up, with or without IT knowledge. But when things require a bit of configuration, these tips that I've shared with you should become very helpful. If you plan to work in professional audio, I'd recommend you go ahead and go through the Dante Level 1 and Level 2 certifications, which you can access free with the links below the video. These go into much more detail than I've gone into here, and it's also a very useful certification to have on your resume.